My name is B. Nagesh. I'm a retired civil servant. I was selected twice in the civil services examination. In fact, the civil services examination, the three stages of prelim, mains, and interview, was first introduced in 1980. So, in the 1980 exam, I cleared the interview and I was selected for a Group A services. Then again in 1981, I was also selected for the Group A services. In the meanwhile, I appeared for the state civil services in Karnataka. I secured the first rank as selected as assistant commissioner. After my voluntary retirement from the state civil services, I took voluntary retirement as additional secretary to government and as also secretary for the RTI. I've been guiding students from 2011. In the preparation for the civil services. So today I do a topic on issues relating to agriculture. As I told you, General Studies 3 consists of economy, agriculture, science, technology and environment, disaster management, internal security. So the issues relating to agriculture, they carry, if I see the previous papers, right from the last 3-4 years, agriculture gets around 50 to 60 marks every year. And why the government has introduced these topics in the component of agriculture? See, as a civil servant, you should know the basic aspects of the working of the economy. See, like say today we do something on the PDS, public distribution system. See, the General Studies 3, agriculture part of the syllabus is all basic elements which a civil servant should know when entering service. Like say cropping pattern, public distribution system, food security, working of the storage system, then working of the other related components of agriculture, like animal husbandry, then livestock, all this, the basic issues a civil servant is supposed to know. So today's discussion, we do a topic on issues related to agriculture, public distribution system. See the question, improvement in nutritional status has not kept pace with economic growth. Improvement in nutritional status has not kept pace with economic growth. In the light of the statement, analyze the role of PDS in determining nutritional outcomes. So what the examiner is trying to analyze from you is, you may have read a lot about the public distribution system, the components, the merits, the shortcomings. See, now your answer will have to be confined to the question. The question is whether PDS has promoted or got about an improvement in nutritional status. So before we start the discussion, we have a general introduction. See, the public distribution system, you see how it came about. It came about in the era of food shortages to provide food grains at low cost. Later on, we had the Green Revolution. Now the public distribution system was later on modified into the targeted PDS. Targeted PDS is for the vulnerable groups. Later on, we have the National Food Security Act of 2013, which promises food security through the PDS. This is just an introductory para to the answer. What are the challenges faced? Like, why has the PDS not been able to get an improvement in nutritional status? The first thing, inaccurate identification of households. See, a study by the erstwhile Planning Commission, this is before Niti Aayog, the erstwhile Planning Commission, a study says 25% of the non-poor have been included. That means they are not eligible to be included in the scheme. In that, 25% of non-poor are included, and 67% of the eligible who have to be included, they were excluded. So this is the glaring statistics given by the former planning commission, that is the body preceding the Niti Aayog. The planning commission study says the households have not been identified properly. Leakages in delivery. By leakages in delivery, I mean a lot of ghost cards where beneficiaries don't exist. So this is only an objective to siphon food grains to the open market. The third, cost of food subsidies. By this I mean, see, the cost of procurement and the price which are given to the beneficiary. There's a lot of difference, and the food subsidy, the burden is placed by the government. It has to be borne by the government. See, earlier, the procurement was during, and then, okay, we talk of procurement. Now, the agency for the PDS, implementing the PDS under the National Security Act, is the Food Corporation of India. So, what happens during a period of drought? What happens during a period of domestic shortfall? The price fluctuation will be there. Again, this affects the working of the PDS. Consumption under the targeted public distribution system was only 60%. See, now the object of the PDS and later on the TDPS is to provide subsidized food grains at low price. Now our study says consumption under the TDPS was only 60%, and the extent of leakages is in the range of 40%. Then cost of handling, the labor costs, energy. So all this, the cost of handling, this causes a strain on the working of the public distribution system. Unscientific storage. Not only we are faced with the issue of unscientific storage, which is leading to rotting of food grains, but we are also faced with the imbalance in storage capacity. Certain states having very good storage facilities, certain states do not have adequate storage facilities. In fact, the Controller and Auditor General in one of the reports has pointed out that this imbalance in storage capacity has to be rectified. Low utilization of existing capacity. Okay, whatever existing capacity you have that is not being utilized properly. So the Supreme Court, in one of the judgments, it has pointed out how the existing storage facilities have to be augmented, used to the maximum capacity. Then, see, there is a point on environment sustainability. What do I mean by environment sustainability? See, cultivating the crops which are water intensive. What is happening is, this is leading to rapid depletion of groundwater resources. Then the soil and water conditions are getting affected because of overuse of fertilizers. So environmental sustainability is another challenge for the working of the PDS. So this part of the answer, what I have stressed is why the PDS has not been able to promote or secure improvement in nutritional status. I have mentioned the challenges. So then the next part of the answer, you would have to mention what reforms, how you can strengthen this. So first thing, what I suggest is digitization of ration cards. Of course, the government is doing it in a big way. So digitization of ration cards will check the problem of ghost beneficiaries and pilferage. Computerized allocation to the fair price shops. So computerized allocation to fair price shops, you know, what is the allotment made, how much the shop has lifted, how much is the balance, everything we will come to know. Smart cards, GPS to track movement of trucks. In fact, in Karnataka, it is there, other in other parts of the, in other parts of the country also, the trucks are painted in yellow color so that they can be tracked, so that they can be spotted. There's a need for a web-based portal to register grievances. this could be done even at the level of the shop. So this web-based portal, you can register, required for you to register grievances regarding the distribution of the food grains and whether you are getting it on time and other related issues. Cash transfers, food coupons are another method of strengthening the public distribution system. Now recently the government came about with the scheme of One Nation, One Ration Card to help the migrant laborers to ensure portability of the ration card so that a person can draw in where he goes, whichever part of the country he goes. So these are the measures which you can suggest to strengthen. Coming back to the question, see the question says, examine the role of PDS in determining nutritional outcomes. So your answer, what you will have to do is, first you'll have to break up the answer into two bits. The first part of it would be, highlight the challenges. You show the weaknesses in the functioning of the public distribution system. See here, you're not being critical of government. You're only quoting the reports of the Planning Commission. You're only quoting the report of the CAG. You're only quoting the report of the Supreme Court. So you're safe. You're not criticizing the system. You're only highlighting what are the issues which are preventing improvement in nutritional status. Then your answer will not be complete unless you suggest how this imbalance can be rectified. As I told you, strengthening, you provide technological solutions, that is digitization, smart cards, tracking trucks through GPS, web-based portal for grievance redressal, cash transfers, food coupons, and the recently announced One Nation, One Ration Card. So if you split up your answer like this, your answer becomes complete. So today we have discussed one particular topic relating to agriculture, that is working of the public distribution system. In this presentation, I have tried to cover the most relevant points which are necessary for the answer, because what will happen is, for 200 words, that is for about 20 lines or 25 lines, depending on how many words you put on one line. This is the utmost you can write for an answer. So this is a general discussion on the issues relating to agriculture, public distribution system. So I suggest additional, if you would like to read another additional material, go through the Economic Survey, Volume 2. But don't bother yourself with too much statistics, too many facts and figures, because the examiner wants to know whether you have understood the question. See, you may have read so much about the PDS, but you have to link your knowledge of whatever you know of the PDS, link it to the question asked. That is all. Don't spend too much of time on any question. In fact, in the mains, when you have to answer so many questions, the trick in qualifying for the interview would be answering all the questions. Don't leave out any question. Whatever little you know, attempt the question and do justice to all the questions. That way you would stand a better chance of clearing the mains and entering the interview. Thank you.